We're all familiar with seeing high voltage power lines next to roads, and also lower voltage power inside our homes. However, beyond just voltage level, there are many other factors that make these systems different. In this video, we'll be discussing single phase and three phase power. We'll broadly go over the basics and then discuss many of the practical considerations and choices required when setting up an electrical system. Single phase and three phase power are cornerstones of nearly all AC electrical systems, so it's important to properly understand how they're set up. Whether it's for safely installing a new hookup or upgrading an existing system, it's always good to go over the basics. Single and three-phase systems both operate using AC power. AC power uses alternating voltage potential fields to generate alternating currents to feed loads, usually at 60 Hz or 60 cycles per second. We'll see that we can take advantage of this cyclical behavior, but first, let's just define what phase means in a power system. A phase is any individual AC signal. The number of phases a system has refers to how many of these will be used to power your system, which is exactly how many incoming conductors there will be. Outside, you may be able to see three utility power lines. This is because power is generated and distributed in three phases. Your house will likely tap off only one of these lines, meaning that your home will be fed with single-phase power. Common AC power diagrams can tell us a little more about these incoming signals. Many single-phase systems will only have one sinusoid with an amplitude of 120 volts and frequency of 60 Hz. A three-phase system will have three phases overlapping, one for each incoming phase, commonly labeled A, B, and C. As you can imagine, different system types require different sorts of wiring, so let's take a look at some simple schematics. Here's a simple single-phase transformer that would provide a single-phase source of power. Current must flow in a loop out of the transformer and back to it, so in order to feed a load, we'll need two wires. A hot that serves as the incoming power, and a neutral that serves as a return path to complete the loop. Residential systems will use a variation of this single phase circuit called split phase. Split phase will literally split the single phase into half by moving the neutral to the center of the transformer secondary, leaving two separate circuit loops that are 180 degrees out of phase, or one larger loop with twice the voltage. On the other hand, three-phase power requires a conductor for each incoming phase. Depending on the transformer configuration, there may or may not be a neutral in the system. Presence of a neutral will determine whether you have what's known as a three or four wire system. For example, a delta system will only have three line conductors, while a Y system will have an extra connection for the neutral, which gives the flexibility to power single phase loads connected line to line or line to neutral. In general, three phase power has three main benefits over single phase power. One, the power transmitted with three wires in a three-phase system would require six wires across three equivalent single-phase circuits. Two, three-phase power is usually fed from a larger electrical source, which provides much steadier voltage. This is required by many heavier commercial loads, such as motors. And finally, three, three-phase systems can feed both single and three-phase loads, while single-phase systems are designed to only feed single-phase loads. We'll talk about the electrical loads in more detail later, but for now, this is a good stopping point to talk about where different voltages come from. For residential setups, the system will likely be fed with split phase power. This means that there will be two available circuits in your house that run 120 volts when measuring line to neutral. This is enough voltage for most plug loads and smaller electronics, but some appliances like air conditioning units or electric dryers require more power to operate. For these cases, we can supply them with 240 volts by making a line to line connection, or taking the differential between the two 120 volt lines instead of with neutral. With either the 240 volt circuit or 120 volt circuits, there's only one hot and one return, so these are still considered single phase circuits. Some commercial buildings will need a mix of low and high power loads. In this case, to save on electrical infrastructure, a three phase Y transformer can be used. Like mentioned before, the advantage of a Y transformer over other three phase configurations is the neutral connection. Lower power plug loads can be taken from an individual phase to neutral, offering 120 volt single phase, while higher power loads requiring steady three phase voltage can be stacked on line to line connections for 208 volts. The 208 comes from the transformer relation line to line voltage equals square root of 3 times line to neutral voltage. A common higher power version of the same Y configuration is available with 277 line to neutral voltage, most often for lighting, and 480 line to line voltage, usually for heavy motor loads. Three-phase delta configurations usually provide high-capacity line-to-line voltage, typically 240, 480, or 600 volts. For some applications with 240 volts, one of the legs can be center-grounded to create a new reference point. For example, a 240-volt delta with a center-ground tap can offer the three normal 240-volt line-to-line connections for motors, two additional 120-volt line-to-ground legs similar to split-phase like a residential service, and one 208-volt connection as well for special applications. This is known as a high leg delta. There are many common voltages on three-phase power systems at the utility level too. This table highlights some typical three-phase power distribution voltages for medium voltage utility power systems. While wiring a system may seem intuitive, the electrical loops or current flows may not be what you expect. In particular, understanding the different role that the neutral wire plays in single and three-phase systems is key to understanding how current flows and what may make a system balanced or unbalanced. In a single branch system, or a system where each phase has its own neutral, the neutral wire will carry all of the return current just like we expect. However, in a balanced multi-branch system, or a system where multiple phases share a single neutral, the neutral actually won't have any current. Instead, the current will return on the other phases, which are at complementary points in their cycle. Let's go back to the graphs to make sense of this. Looking at the supply voltage for a three-phase system, the relation between the three phases is important to see. First, they all run at the same frequency. Second, they're shifted apart 120 degrees. And third, the amplitudes are the same, meaning that they're balanced. Let's look at the currents in the system. We can see that the first two properties, frequency and phase shift, are preserved. If the loads are balanced, then the amplitudes will also match up. To understand why no current flows in the neutral when the system is balanced, draw a line through all three phase currents and add them together. The resulting current will actually be zero at any point in time. This is what having a fully balanced load means. If you have 100 amps on each phase, the instantaneous total should be zero based on them being 120 degrees apart, demonstrating that current flowing out on one phase will flow back in on the other two phases at the same time. Now, a three-phase system without a neutral could also have unbalanced currents, but they would still have to add up to zero or power would be restricted. Having a neutral allows for full power operation with unbalanced currents on each individual phase. A mostly balanced system won't carry too much current on the neutral, but poorly balanced systems can have significant amounts. In an extreme case, a single phase load on a three-phase system would have all of its current on one phase and returning on the neutral. This is why the neutral wire must be sized at least as large as the other conductors, oftentimes even larger today to account for extra harmonic content. To actively balance the system, we need to design for equal loading on each leg of the transformer. This will help transmit power much more efficiently and lower excess heat in the system, extending the life of the transformer. Most three-phase loads will draw even amounts of current per phase, so it's mostly single-phase loads on the three-phase system that need to be considered. Depending on the application, loads will require different voltage levels. Some require three-phase, some require single-phase, and still others may require a combination of both. In industrial applications, facilities will be designed for higher voltage three-phase power. This feeds many different types of power-hungry equipment, 70-80% of which are three-phase motors. Commercial buildings also run on three-phase power, but they usually draw less energy. Loads are broken up into three even categories: lighting for the whole building, plug loads like everyday electronics, and heavy motor loads for functions like HVAC. The motors will require three-phase, while lighting and plug loads only need single-phase. And finally, residential settings will use the least amount of power, so they really only use single-phase. Heavy-duty appliances may require 240 volts, but nearly everything else will only use 120 volts. In this video, we covered single and three-phase systems, common electrical infrastructure and electrical loads, and the importance of balancing multi-phase systems. There's a lot to know, and this is hardly the beginning. To learn more about single-phase and three-phase systems and how you can design your own electrical system, contact us or your local Eden representative to schedule a visit to one of Eden's Power Systems Experience Centers today.